apart from the fact that one third of children in school cannot even tackle class one language and mathematics, the fact that the others who might be able to get some marks and pass, that raises many other questions. They might be quote unquote brilliant in class 10 and 12 exams, but the question is that do they fulfill any particular need of this country? Do they have values which would make them sensitive to these questions of education where exclusion is such a big problem? Or are they just mere technical professionals who are looking for a wealthier future but are not bothered about other aspects of what we may call citizenship? Are we producing those kind of citizens? If you look around at the number of people who burn buses, who bring down mosques, who attack temples, who molest and rape women, who regularly go about anything that happens and they're in opposition to that, or the way they drive in Delhi, you would think that they're uneducated. Every time you see a driver on a road in Delhi, the first thing that comes to your mind is, why is he so uneducated? So therefore, even those children, about 5 or 6 crores, who you may say are learning something, what are they learning? Are they learning to be sensible citizens of this country? Or as just about, are they learning to be good human beings? So does education have to do anything with that? So these are the larger questions about education that one might raise when you go beyond class 10 exams and what grades you got and which college admissions you got or you didn't get. There's not been such a big dearth of policy frameworks and so on in education. I mean, we had the Radhakrishnan Commission report for higher education, which you probably read in your courses. We had the Mudaliar Commission report, but one of the landmark policy documents is the Kothari Commission of 1966. Landmark because it went into many of these questions in probably great detail and with a very good sense of linking education to national development. It went into the question of social segregation. And for many reasons, therefore, we don't have a better document than that. Then we had the 68 policy, then the 86 policy, which was revised in 92. So therefore, we have had a policy framework continuously since independence, but quite obviously it has not been enough to solve the kind of problem that I just described to you. It's been inadequate in creating a educational base at the school level, which would be better than what I mentioned. Any ordinary 5-year, 6-year-old girl or boy, you ask and say, padhna chahogi? And would say, haan, padhna chahte hain. And to me, that is sufficient reason for us to say we must address this problem. 1937 mein Gandhi ji ne pehli dafa kaha tha ki shiksha universal honi chahiye. This is also the time when, under the self-rule, 8 presidencies of India had Congress governments. So, halanki azadi nahi mili thi, par 8 presidency mein Congress ki sarkare aayi thi. And Gandhi addressed this question to them and saying that you should try to bring in universal education. But beginning from that time, you may say that the elements of the state have shown a reluctance to do it. Halanki unka stature jis tarah ka tha 1937 mein, unko bhi logon ne bataya, Congress ke logon ne jo ye sarkar chalate the, ki bada mushkil hai, paise nahi hai. We don't have that kind of economic strength. Baad mein Gandhi ji ko kaise mana karte, to unke samne unne ek vikalp rakha. They told Gandhi that the only way to raise money is to have excise from liquor. Sharab ki tax se jo paisa milega, shayad usse kar sakte hain. Now Gandhi was equally for prohibition. वो तो शराब विरोधी थे तो उन्होंने लिखा भी एक स्वराज के आर्टिकल में कि ये तो बड़ी अजीब विडंबना है कि हम बच्चों को शिक्षा नहीं दे सकते हैं जब तक कि हम शराब ज्यादा न बेचें तो अगर शराब से हमें बच्चों को शिक्षा देनी है तो मैं फिर अपनी डिमांड छोड़ देता हूँ. एंड दैट वॉज द रीजन फॉर गांधी टू गेट इन टू द फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ द नई तालीम. वेयर द प्राइमरी रीजन वाई ही गॉट इन टू नई तालीम वॉज दैट कैन बी फंड एजुकेशन इंटरनली सो दैट वी आर नॉट डिपेंडेंट ऑन स्टेट फंड्स एंड एक्सटर्नल. तो क्राफ्ट बेस्ड एजुकेशन जहाँ बच्चे हाथ से काम करेंगे और जो वो बनाएंगे उसको बेचा जाएगा और जो वो बेचा जाएगा उसे स्कूल चलेगा, विच वॉज एट द हार्ट ऑफ हिज फॉर्मुलेशंस ऑफ नई तालीम. देयर वॉज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डॉक्यूमेंट दैट वॉज मेड इन 1944 कॉल्ड द सार्जेंट कविटी रिपोर्ट. दिस इज अ ब्लू प्रिंट इन अ सेंस फॉर हाउ एजुकेशन शुड बी फॉर एन इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया. सार्जेंट कमिटी रिपोर्ट सेड दैट यूनिवर्सल एजुकेशन इन इंडिया विल नॉट बी अचीव्ड फॉर 40 ईयर्स. So its target was something like 1985, that we can only think of 40 years span by which time universal education would come. In fact, Gandhi ji ne jab unko kaha gaya ki hum nahi kar sakte hain, unhone kaha tha ki fir to 100 saal mein bhi hamari shiksha mein sabhi bacche nahi aayenge. I don't know 100 saal mein ho gaya nahi, 70 saal to ho gaye, but somewhere his calculation of time frames was better. Now it is with this background when we come to the formulation of our constitution.